In the previous part of this lesson, we studied the problem of variable length encoding and how you can try to create code words that minimize the average bit length. The structural property that we saw in the end of part one was that the optimal encoding is such that the two symbols with the lowest frequency appear at the maximum depth of the corresponding binary tree. So now we can actually see the algorithm that Huffman came up with in the late 50s to solve this problem. Again, the same section. Let's actually look at an example and create the algorithm ourselves based on what we know so far. So these are four symbols and the corresponding frequencies. What is the code word set that will actually give us the minimum average bit length? We know that the two symbols with the lowest frequency, in this case B and C, will appear at the maximum depth at the bottom of the corresponding tree. So we can start in a bottom-up manner by placing those two symbols at the bottom. And of course, given that the tree has to be binary and full, these two will be siblings. They will both have the same parent, some internal node of the binary tree. Now, we don't know what is at the higher levels of this tree at this point yet, but what we can do at this point is we can essentially think of this internal node as a new symbol that represents both B and C, and the frequency of that symbol will be what? Will be the sum of the frequencies of B and C. In other words, 5 plus 10. This new symbol will be in the alphabet 15% of the time. Why is that? Because whenever we're trying to go from the root up here to either B or C, we have to traverse this node. So we're traversing this internal node 15% of the time. Now that we have this new symbol, we can essentially forget B and C. Imagine that our alphabet now doesn't include these two letters. Again, we are applying the structural property we previously saw, and we ask, which are the two symbols with a minimum frequency at this point? Well, one of them is this new symbol, BC, with frequency 15%, and the other is symbol D, with frequency 25%. So we create now a node, a leaf actually, for the node D. This will be sibling of this node that corresponds to the symbol BC. And given that D has a frequency of 25%, the new internal node that we create here will have a frequency of 40%. So this new internal node that we create, it corresponds to the symbol BCD, right, as we did before. At this point, we can forget these two symbols, the symbol D and the symbol BC. Imagine that they don't exist. So the only symbols that we have at this point are the symbol A with frequency 60% and the frequency BCD with frequency 40%. So these two, clearly they will have to be siblings. They both are children of the root node. And without loss of generality, we can give 0 to one of them and 1 to the other. So if we apply the same convention as we did before, 0 for the left child and 1 for the right child, at this point we have the complete binary tree. So the code word for A at this point is 1, just a single bit. The code word for B is 000. The code word for C is 001. And the code word for D is 01. So now that we have actually these code words, if you want, you can even calculate the average bit length of this encoding, which would be as we discussed before, the summation across all of these four symbols of their frequency, which is what's shown here, times the length of the code word, which is also the depth of the corresponding letter in the tree. If you do the calculations, you will get 1.55 bits per symbol, which is of course less than a fixed length encoding scheme that would give 2 bits to each of these four symbols. I think the previous example should be quite clear, and it suggests how to write the algorithm more generally. We can create a priority queue using, for instance, a binary heap in which we keep track of the frequencies of the symbols, either the original symbols that we started with or the symbols that represent these internal nodes that we create during the execution of the algorithm. So let's write the algorithm in that manner. The input of the algorithm is an array of symbols with their frequencies, and the output of the algorithm will be the code word. As we discussed, you can represent those code words with a full binary tree. The algorithm will create a priority queue that is ordered by this frequency F. And initially, we just initialize the priority queue by inserting in the priority queue each symbol with the associated frequency. And then we have a for loop, which is from n plus 1 to 2 times n minus 1. I will explain why we have 2n minus 1 in a second. First, find the two symbols, I and J, that have the smallest frequencies. So we delete them from the binary heap. And what we do is we create a new node named K with frequency Fi plus Fj. So this is the internal node that we created that will replace the symbols I and J. This node K is the parent of the leaves I and J, in other words. And of course, we set the frequency of that node to be Fi plus Fj. And we insert that node K in the binary heap. And then we repeat. So what happens in every iteration of this loop is that we are deleting two nodes and we are creating one node. So eventually, it will reach the point that it only has one node that corresponds to the root. Why do we do this from n plus 1 to 2 times n minus 1? Because this is the total number of nodes in a full binary tree. So the first n nodes are the leaves of that tree, and the rest of the nodes from n plus 1 to 2 times n minus 1 is all of the internal nodes that we will create, including the root. Now, given that we are implementing this using a priority queue with a binary heap, all of these operations that you see here on the binary heap take log n, and so the total number of operations that we need to perform in this algorithm is n log n, where n is the number of symbols. Let's now explain why Huffman's algorithm is optimal. So remember that in every iteration of the algorithm, we go from a binary tree with n leaves to a binary tree with one less leaf, n minus one leaves. And the way we do that is we find in this binary tree Tn the two leaves I and J that have the lowest frequency, and they appear at the maximum depth. So let's say that I appears at the frequency Fi and J appears at the frequency Fj, and we replace these two leaves with another leaf that corresponds to the new symbol Ij, And this symbol has frequency, as we discussed, fi plus fj. And this symbol now appears not at the depth dmax, but dmax minus 1, right? Because we have replaced these two leaves with their parent. So, looking at the difference between the average bit length of the tree tn and the average bit length that corresponds to the tree tn minus 1, we have this term for these symbols here at the depth dmax minus the new symbol that appears with frequency fi plus fj, but it appears at the depth of dmax minus 1. So this is of course equal to the sum of the frequencies of these two elements. So imagine now how the algorithm proceeds from the initial tree tn to a tree with n minus 1 leaves, n minus 2 leaves, all the way it will eventually become a tree with 0 leaves, that of course is the root. So if we apply this recursive formula again and again from the initial tree until we reach the root, we get that the average bit length of the tree that we start with n leaves, minus the average bit length of the final tree that doesn't have any leaves, it's just the root. This is a summation of this term, but for every iteration. So let me write this as fi when the tree has k leaves, plus fj when the tree has k leaves. So, and we do that from the case that the tree has 2 leaves all the way to when it has n leaves. So, in the original difference that you see here, the tree had n leaves, and we find the two nodes with the minimum frequency in that tree. The last term is when we only have the root with two children, and that corresponds to the case that k is equal to 2. So what I want you to see here is two things. The first is that the average bit length of this tree that is only the root, this is simply 0, because in that case we don't have to represent any symbols, we have 0 symbols. And what happens here is that in each of these terms that we are adding the lowest possible frequency term. There is no other pair of symbols in the corresponding tree that would have a lower frequency sum than these two symbols. So since we are adding in every iteration the smallest possible sum, this is the minimum average bit length that we can get. This shows that the average bit length of the tree that is constructed by Huffman's algorithm has the minimum average bit length. In other words, it is the optimal encoding tree.